Last night I caught a program by a guy called Louis Theroux, who a lot of you in Britain will know, and I'm not sure if you will know in America, but certainly a lot of what he does is in America because it looks at the kind of extremes of human behaviour and beliefs and practices, a lot of which can be found over there. And of course, looking at it from an external perspective, it is all the more so. And this is pertinent to the topic, actually, because this particular program was about Americans keeping wild animals as pets. I won't go into the details of this program or the intricacies. I'll try and find it and put a link. But what struck me particularly were the chimpanzees that were being kept and caged for because they were dangerous. In fact, one of the places where we were shown was the place where the chimpanzee who ripped the woman's face off came from. And you throw your hands up in horror, don't you? Shouldn't be keeping dangerous animals like that. I'd like to throw a slightly different perspective on that. Looking at these creatures who are minutely different from us genetically, we're more similar than we are different. Locked up in very small cages, at worse than you could ever imagine a prison to be. And then telling everybody that they're in there because they're dangerous. I would say they're dangerous because they're in there. If you had been locked into a confined space against your will for years, and you got the small opportunity to either get out or dole out a little bit of payback, wouldn't you? Wouldn't anyone? And this woman, this program was saying, "Oh, yes, they love me." But these, clearly agitated, bored, enraged creatures, very like ourselves. I think we have to start thinking about creatures other than ourselves as non-human animals, or just that we're all somehow that we get it into our head that we are all just creatures trying to live out our existence. And why is one's more valid than another, or why does one have the right to impose imprisonment or whatever on another? Now, how far we take that has to be up to each individual conscience. I don't think you can impose that on someone else. Well, you can try, but I don't think it ever works. Often it has the opposite effect, in fact. But until we start viewing this from a more realistic perspective, it is us who are barbaric, us who are primitive, not them.